Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. Today is the final day of all the presentations, and we are the final presenters. Please enjoy to the end. Do you know what happened at 2:46 p.m. on March 11, 2011? Everything became chaos at that moment. Please watch this video.
ああ、終わりだ、何も。
When I was American and Japanese people, most people said it was like a movie. But it actually happened. These are our topics. My name is Yuri. I'll introduce understanding earthquakes.
My name is Karin. I'll introduce about effects and damage and suffering in Tohoku.
My name is Miu. I'd like to talk about Japanese wonderful resilience.
Through the Tohoku earthquake, I got the opportunity to think about earthquakes. So first, I'd like you to understand earthquakes. These are my subtopics. Myths of the past.The facts of the Tohoku earthquake and tsunami, and the severity of the Tohoku earthquake. First, I'll introduce myths of the past. Before people believed in science, Japanese people had a story about the causes of earthquakes. Japanese believed a popular myth, which was the cause of earthquake.Japanese common catfish exist deep in the ground. An earthquake happens when the catfish struggles to be free itself. Actually, Kajima Shrine has a stone. It means to suppress this catfish, and it's also believed as a guardian deity against earthquakes. Also, Japan has another myth. If slender oar fish, which is deep sea fish, was washed ashore,It's called a messenger, the coming of an earthquake because of the rare fish. Actually, around last March, March 2010, there was news. Out of slender oar fish were washed ashore in each coastal area in the Tohoku region. And next year, the big Tohoku earthquake happened. Next,I'll talk about the facts of the Tohoku earthquake and tsunami. Since ancient times, many kinds of natural disasters have happened in Japan. Especially earthquakes happen frequently because of four huge tectonic plates. On March 11, 2011, the Tohoku earthquake happened. It was magnitude 9.0.The center of the earthquake was northern part of Japan. After the earthquake, the big tsunami happened. The average height of a wave was over 33 feet. The highest wave was 132 feet, which is almost the same as a 15-story building. After that, the ground had sunk about 3 feet in the area.There were many casualties, but also many people became refugees. The tsunami created over 300,000 refugees. At refugee camps, over 280 people died. because of unclean conditions and cold weather. Finally, I'll talk about the severity of the Tohoku earthquake through the comparison to other earthquakes. First, I'd like to compare the Tohoku and the 1906 San Francisco earthquake. As you know, the 1906 San Francisco earthquake on April 18, 1906 was a major earthquake that hit San Francisco, California, and the coast of Northern California. It was magnitude 7.9. The casualty was over 3,000. Compared to the Tohoku earthquake, it was magnitude 9.0. The casualty is now 15,840, which is almost five times of the casualty of the San Francisco earthquake. Next, I'd like to compare the Tohoku and the Hanshin Awaji earthquake. Before the Tohoku earthquake, the Hanshin Awaji earthquake on January 18, 1995 was the biggest earthquake in Japanese history. The earthquake hit the southern part of Hyogo Prefecture, which is near Nishinomiya and the Mukogawa Women's University. When I was 3 years old, this earthquake happened. It was magnitude 7.3. The casualty was 6,434. The number of three missing was three. Compared to the Tohoku earthquake, the casualty is now 15,840, which is more than double of the casualty of Hanshin Awaji earthquake. The number of three missing is now 3,546. Unfortunately, the casualty and the number of three missing are still increasing. In addition, compared to the Tohoku and the Hanshin Awaji earthquake on the cause of death, most of them were drowned. The rest were crushed or burned to death. On the other hand, in the Hanshin Awaji earthquake, most of them were crushed to death under houses. The rest were crushed to death under furniture. The statistics show that tsunami is related deeply to the cause of death in the Tohoku earthquake. In my conclusion, since ancient times, a lot of natural disasters, especially earthquakes, happen frequently. But on March 11, 2011, the Tohoku ever worst earthquake happened. The earthquake caused the big tsunami, and because of that, the number of victims was much higher. Through the Tohoku earthquake, I would like you to tell how terrible natural disasters are. Next, Karin will talk about the damage and the suffering in Tohoku. Thank you!
Thank you, Yuri, for interesting information. My name is Karin. As Yuri said, I would like to talk about damage and suffering in Tohoku. First, look at these pictures. How do you feel? Probably you feel shock and sadness. Although fortunately, my hometown was safe. I can't help thinking of the victims of this earthquake. So I would like you to know about the truth and imagine this terrible situation. So I would like to tell you about effect of natural disaster in Tohoku. The terrible damage to the nuclear power plant. After the earthquake, after the disaster, people's life in Tohoku. First, let me start by effect of natural disaster in Tohoku. No one had expected the tsunami would came over the embankment, which was said to be the strongest in Japan. After the tsunami came over the embankment, the cities soon changed into an ocean. It took only 5 minutes. A person who experienced a Tohoku earthquake said, I didn't notice the coming wave because I could see and hear nothing. Why? Because the embankment blocked the coming wave, but also it prevented the people from seeing and hearing the wave. Because of these reasons, many people delayed to evacuating. The earthquake and tsunami were very dangerous. In addition, there are nuclear power plant problems. Earthquake and tsunami caused the problem at Fukushima nuclear power plant along coast in northern part of Japan. Water from the tsunami struck the cooling system and it stopped and overheated. And nuclear meltdown started and finally spread the dangerous radiation into the air. Next, let me tell you a little more about the terrible damage to nuclear power plant. Many people who live in Tohoku worry about exposure to radiation. But even worse was a psychological effect. After the earthquake, many children have a fever, vomiting, and diarrhea because of acute stress disorder. It comes from shock, fear, a change in environment. Even newborn babies have this disorder, and their hair may fall out, and they may bang their head against the floor. Whenever it gets worse, it is called post-traumatic disorder. Suddenly they remember their fear, and they will be sleepless and forgetful. Actually, many children have this disorder, and they can't sleep without their parents. Not only humans, but also many animals suffer from radiation. About 99% of inhabitants took refuge in other cities, and Tohoku was like a zoo. Look at this picture. Many animals lost their owners, and they went out from their fences and wandered looking for food. However, a lot of animals die because of the lack of nutrition. In this situation, farmers grieve for the loss of a lot of animals. Animals that are still living have radiation problem, so farmers suffered even more deeply. Finally, let me tell you about after the disaster, people's life in Tohoku. Thousands of people lost their houses and 400,000 people took refuge in emergency relief shelters. In July, the environment was bad with an unsanitary condition and it was easy to catch an illness because of the rising temperatures. There are a lot of rotten fish and garbage were accumulated in this earthquake area. A lot of mosquitoes and flies appeared spreading disease. That's why the percentage of illness was high. Also, people got food poisoning because there was little food, so they wanted to keep their food. However, in summer, food spoiled very easily because of the heat. Because of these reasons, the refugee camps were not safe. After the earthquake, there are individual crimes such as looting gasoline, money, goods, and breaking into ATMs. After the earthquake, there are no gasoline in Tohoku, so there are a lot of people who wanted to get it. For example, people wanted to escape from this earthquake area, and people wanted to go to hospital because they had family there. There are a lot of reasons people committed crimes. However, most vicious crime was the people posing as volunteers who came from other city, and they still stole things from the houses and cars in this earthquake area. In my conclusion, A great number of the people suffered earthquake, tsunami, and nuclear power plant, and they evacuated to the refugee camps. However, their worry has continued, and they wondered whether there is hope or not. Can you believe this terrible situation? I don't want to believe, but it's true. However, the victim of this earthquake has tried to advance with a strong mind, little by little. Next, we will introduce about recovery of Tohoku earthquake. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Karin. Karin's information would make you sad or shocked, but about 9 months has already passed and Tohoku has gradually gone back to the former environment. So next, I'd like to talk about recovery from the Tohoku earthquake. And my name is Miu, and this is my title, Japanese Wonderful Resilience. And these are my subtopics, and support within Japan, Japanese national characteristics, and international support. And first, I'd like to start with support within Japan. Many companies sent lots of donations to Tohoku. For example, food company send their food, drink company send their drink, and pharmaceutical company send their medicine. And not only supplies, but also they send lots of service. And cell phone company offered free Wi-Fi spot and message board. And internet and social network were also helpful because at that time, Tohoku was swamped by phone call, so through the internet and social network, they can communicate with other areas people or other sufferers, and they can exchange information each other. So Japanese companies' power is still so strong even though the GDP is dropping. And Japanese, lots of Japanese musicians, comedians, and CEOs donated money to Tohoku, but the support from the professional athlete was amazing. As you know, people who prospered in the US, like baseball player Ichiro, also donated money to Tohoku, but the person who gave the most largest contribution was Ryo Ishikawa. He's a professional golfer, and surprisingly, his age is same as mine. So he is only 20 years old, but he donates all his prize money this year and $1,000 for each party. So totally, he donates $2 million to Tohoku. And all Japanese nation wanted to do any little thing if it is helpful to earthquake victims. We raised money and we went there as volunteers, and all of us tried to save on electricity. And because of the Fukushima nuclear power plant, we didn't have enough electricity power after the earthquake. And so, railroad company reduced the number of train and they turned off the light in train. And at the beginning of September, I left Japan to come here. But still, I saw lots of TV commercials about saving electricity. So how to save on electricity was a big challenge for Japanese and for Japanese. And next, I'd like to talk about Japanese national characteristics. Japanese people are really generous, and lots of people lost their houses and suffered evacuated to refugee camps. And right after the earthquake occurred, there was not enough space for everyone, and food and blanket also lacked. So governments or famous people sent reliefs or visited Tohoku to hand out supplies to earthquake victims. And everyone was hungry, and everyone needed something to protect against the cold. But all sufferers made a line to get supplies, and they waited their own turn. And sometimes it took 8 hours. Yeah. So this story can tell us how Japanese people are kind to each other and patient. And Japanese people respect each other. The awful earthquake After the awful earthquake occurred, there was no disturbances. If a natural big disaster happened in other country, some riot would probably break out. And as Karin said, some individual crime was actually happened, but we didn't have group riots. So foreign people said, it's amazing and it's unbelievable. And Japanese had never had such a problem, even though lots of natural disaster happened in Japan. So we should proud our wonderful character. And Japanese people are really hardworking. The great recovery is thanks to thousands of people's efforts. And the good example of this is the self-defense force, activity of the self-defense force, and it is similar to the US National Guard, and they helped lots of people's lives. So the number of children who want to become a member of self-defense force increased after the Tohoku earthquake. And I've told you about Japanese national characteristics, so finally, we will move on to the international support. 120 countries and areas sent supplies and contribution, and 26 countries dispatched rescue party, rescue dogs, and experts of the nuclear power plant. And especially the support from the US government was incredible. They sent lots of personnel, ships, aircraft, and also they gave lots of food, water, and fuel. So I want to say thank you to American people. And unfortunately, many musicians canceled their concert in Japan because of the earthquake. But one of the most popular singers in the world pioneered to support to Japan. Her name is Lady Gaga. She designed this wristband with the message, we pray for Japan, and if we buy this wristband, we can donate money to Japan. And individually, she raised $1.5 million to Tohoku, so totally, she donates $2.7 million to Japan. And not only that, she visited Japan on July 21st and proved that Japan is a safe and beautiful country to all over the world. And not only government and famous people, lots of foreign citizens gave a big support to Japan. And I found lots of heartwarming messages on YouTube or Twitter. And it is also included from Spokane citizens. When the earthquake was happened, I was here in Spokane and I joined this T-shirt project. And it was started by Mr. Nakamura, who lives in Spokane and he's Japanese. And if we buy this T-shirt, we can donate money to Japan. And the other purpose of this project is when we see a person who wear this T-shirt in the future, we can remember the Tohoku earthquake and its support. So through the Tohoku earthquake, Japanese people recover a pride as a Japanese, and we realize that Japan is supported by the world. So I really want to say thank you to everyone who supported Japan. Thank you for listening. And most of you are wondering the present condition in Tohoku. So finally, I will tell you about that. And now, earthquake victims have three options about housing. And first, they can choose to live in a contemporary prehab housing. But most of them want this option, so they have to go by lottery number. And some of them can't wait their turn for the lottery or don't want to live in Tohoku area anymore, so they move to another city. And the last choice is to continue living in a refugee camp. But this option is for elderly or handicapped people. So Tohoku people still need a long-term support, and honestly, a complete recovery will take a long time.
In our conclusion, in Japan, a lot of natural disasters have happened. Being Japanese means learning to live with natural disasters. But always Japanese have collectively overcome difficulties. On March 11th, the big earthquake, even worst earthquake, happened. However, we can certainly overcome it.
As you know, people in Tohoku lost their families, friends, and their daily lives. Since the same things could happen to us anytime now. That event makes us realize how precious our families, our friends, our ordinary daily lives are. So I would like to thank our families, people who support us, and our destiny, which led us to this stage.
And nobody knows what will happen even at this moment, and actually lots of people in Tohoku left this world without saying thank you to precious people. So our feeling of appreciation must be expressed explicitly, and otherwise it will not reach other people's heart. So when we feel thankful, we should show our gratitude. And finally, please listen our thank you. We are really happy to join the extension program and spend fabulous time together. We are so glad to be here. Thank you, friend.
Thank you, RA.
Thank you, host family.
And thank you, teachers.
Thank you, everyone.
Does anyone have any question? Yes, sir.
So have they started schools in these refugee camps? What do they do with the children?
The question is, does children live in Tohoku area start their school in Tohoku area? And some school was unfortunately broken because of the earthquake, so they can't go to school, their school, but so they go to the school, the closest school in from their house. So, but the school divide two classes, the original student and the new student. So they have new opportunity to go to school, but it is really hard to meet new friends or, yeah.
Classes must be very big.
But divided, so they are not in same classroom, not classmate, just go to same school.
Does anyone have any more questions? Yes, ma'am.
The question is, can the Tohoku people go back to the Tohoku area and can build buildings? The answer is actually no, because still the situation is bad, but the government or the government is strive to build a new building in the Tohoku area, so the situation is getting better than before, but most of people can't go back to the area. Yeah.
Does anyone has any more questions?
Thank you very much, ladies.